Heidel Ball June 2024 just released, and these are the things that we can look forward to. Land of the Morning Light Soul. With this new area, we are getting a new story quest and for sure a brand new adventure log, which I absolutely hate. We are also getting new bosses for the boss shrine and a 5-man co-op boss fight. We are getting a new 5-man co-op boss fight. For the 5-man co-op boss fight, we are going to utilize a different types of aura. If you look at this image, different aura has roles to play in a fight, but most likely it's going to end up like one sun for crowd control and the rest is for earth for the healing mechanic. Now, this is just a crazy assumption of mine, but I can really see this happening. We can now use our own gear in these 5-man boss fights, but we cannot use healing potions and HP recovery skills. This absolutely sucks because these are unnecessary nerfs to cripple us down. Why can't we just have boss fights like any other games out there? Why does this game try so hard to reinvent the boss fights? I just don't get it. If we look at Elden Ring, you fight the bosses based on mechanics. It is like the devs are trying to make things hard for the players. Now, I know I might be jumping to conclusions and overreacting, but like, why though? Why can't we just have a normal 5-man co-op boss fight? I don't want a unique 5-man boss fight that revolves around these stupid auras. Now, they also mentioned that the boss fights are not that hard compared to Attraction. But why do they have to remove potions and HP recovery abilities? It is like they are making an artificial difficulty and inconvenience out of nowhere. And as I've said, I know I might be just overreacting, but I just cannot help it, and the only thing that I can do is just wait and see. The reason why I'm overreacting is because when they released the boss shrine, I was really excited for the new content, but I was disappointed because you can only use 10% of your gear. I didn't do the boss shrine for 6 months because I was pissed simply because we are grinding so hard for our gear, and when finally we get a content where we can utilize our hard-earned gear, we can only use 10% of it. I think they did these nerfs because they really want to implement the boss hour system, which absolutely sucks to be honest, and now they are doing it again by removing the health potion and the HP recovery skills. Now, some of you might argue that you actually didn't lose anything, and you are right about that, but my question is why? Why do we have to go through all that trouble? Why create unnecessary and artificial problems in the first place? Why can't they just design a normal boss fight? Now, I know that sometimes people have to change something in order to spice things up and to be unique. But also do note that being unique doesn't make it useful and in this case, fun. Reinventing the wheel doesn't make the problems that we have go away, but instead create more problems. The boss shrine content would have died if not for the materials needed for the Fallen God gloves and the bonus global buffs. And that is the only reason why players are still doing that content, not because it is fun, but because of the needed materials and the global buffs. The current boss shrine rewards that we have right now are terrible. There is no difference between a reward from a Calamity 1 boss from a Calamity 7 boss. All the rewards are based on RNG. Also, with the brand new update Land of the Morning Light Soul, we are getting the Primordial Weapon Sovereign. To obtain these weapons, you are required to have a Pen Blackstar weapon and combine it with a Primordial Flame. There are also alternatives in obtaining these weapons, such as combining two Black Star weapons and combining a Pen Black Star weapon with a boss weapon with a Kafir's level 20 and a Gem of Twilight. Also, the devs stated that the Gem of Twilight is harder to obtain compared to the Primordial Flame. All these items are obtainable through the new boss shrine and the 5-man co-op boss fight. We are also getting a free Pen Blackstar weapon, which is nice. With this, most of you will obtain more AP, but if you think about it, it is a good thing and a bad thing at the same time. It is good that new adventurers are getting a massive boost in the AP department, and this will open a lot of grind spots in the game. And this also is a very good way to advertise the game to other players who haven't played Black Desert Online. Now for the bad part. Let me remind you guys that I am talking in my own perspective and how I see the game, and this is solely based on my experience. I am a 730 gear score Awakening Guardian. It took me 2 years to get my gear slowly but surely. If you noticed, all my Fallen God armors are still at duo, and you ask, what's the problem with that? The problem is that with the new weapon update, just because you get a free pen black star weapon, it will make things easier, but it is nothing like that. Let me explain. In Southeast Asia server, you get one costume in a week or one every 2 weeks. That is how hard cronstones in this server. It doesn't matter how hard you grind, if you enhance your gear, it will take forever because we simply do not have enough ways to obtain cronstones. Now, we do have Pit of the Undying, but you can only get at least 100 cronstones a day, and as of right now, I have 10,000 Seal of the Undying, which equates to 10,000 cronstones, which I grinded in 100 days. I am now at the verge of burnout and I really don't want to do Pit of the Undying. As a matter of fact, I am still holding my Deboreka belt because I just don't have enough materials to push through. As of now, I still don't have enough cronstones to start my Pen Deboreka belt. I don't even have the silver to buy Jay's hammer for my pen attempts. Going back to the primordial weapons, crafting the damn thing is not a problem. All you have to do is play the game and grind the necessary materials. But enhancing it is a different type of challenge, especially for a guy like me who is free to play and playing in the Southeast Asia server. Not to mention that the primordial weapons can be enhanced from Pride to Death. That is 1 to 10. And that is why I am happy and excited and at the same time dreading this update. As of right now, I still haven't touched my Fallen God armor since the last Heidel ball because I just don't have the cronstones. All my Fallen God armors are destined to be stuck at duo, and as of right now, I am on the verge of burnout. But it doesn't end there. If you guys haven't noticed, getting more AP gets harder when your gear score gets higher. Obtaining AP after reaching 305 bracket will get harder and harder. This is the part that I genuinely hate. Endgame players are getting punished for getting more gear. Getting all these gear is not easy, especially if you are going for the Deboreka accessories. Now with the upcoming update, they did change the AP brackets, but from what I can see, it is not enough and not rewarding enough for me to push hard. And this is another reason why I'm holding back enhancing my Deboreka belt and grinding the Deboreka necklace. Let me give you an idea as to what I am talking about. I have an AP of 307. Let's just use the main hand AP to explain things much easier. Let's say that I finally get a Pen Deboreka belt in my dreams. Do you know how much monster AP I get from this upgrade? Making a Pen Deboreka belt will probably take me hundreds of hours, not including the silver for the Jay's Hammer of Precision or the Cronstones. I get rewarded with a wonderful plus 4 monster AP, a measly 4 monster AP. That is how bad endgame gear is. It is not satisfying. It is very grueling and painful. Now, this is just PvE. In PvP, if you get that kind of upgrade, your mild tickle will probably be like a soft touch, and that is another reason why I never touch my Deboreka belt. Going back to the primordial weapons, I don't really have problems with a very grindy activity as long as it is fun. As of right now, it is dreadful thinking about how I'm going to enhance the damn thing. The enhancing part is the part that I hate, and I wish that I could just buy everything in the central market as an endgame player. But that would probably take thousands of hours just to get one item. Good thing the first descendant is coming up next month, and as of right now, I have Elden Ring Shadow of the Erd 3 to play with. There is also a part where you can create a primordial weapon using 2 Pen Blackstar weapons. And for me, this is absolutely not worth it. If you look at this image, this is a Sovereign Awakening Greatsword at its base form. If you use 2 Pen Blackstar weapons to craft a Sovereign weapon, you just wasted around 100 plus billion silver depending on your server on an item that doesn't give you any AP gain. I think the best way to get the sovereign weapons is to do the new boss shrine and the 5-man co-op boss fights to craft a primordial frame. Now, I know that they are doing this so that the veteran players and the players that are so rich that they can buy the central market have an option to do the new content or not. But the thing is that the materials needed in enhancing the weapons are only obtainable in the new boss content. Now, believe it or not, I'm confused whether I should be happy or not, but what the hell? This is a free Pen Blackstar weapon, and it will surely affect the prices in the market. No wonder they shut down the central market during the Heidel Ball. Also, the primordial weapons have a cool effect, and you can customize it whether you want it on your outfit or not. Also, I think that they mentioned that these color effects or visual effects can be changed by doing some challenges, which is great. The next big update is a new class called Baby Powder. Yes, you heard me, I call it the Baby Powder. If you have a face like that, you absolutely use Baby Powder. Not that it is a bad thing, but like when you compare this guy to a Berserker, you can absolutely tell that this new class is a Baby Powder user. Also, the new class uses Baby Powder for its abilities. He can summon archers and a swordsman made up of Baby Powder, and can also blind enemies using Baby Powder. Now, this class will absolutely come out very OP, because if you haven't noticed, Wusa and Mago came out OP. Any class that comes out in Land of the Morning Light is overpowered. We are also getting an update on Dekia Lantern Tier 2, which will cover Kadri Ruins, Crescent Shrine, Gaifin Rasha Temple, and Miramok Ruins, which require 750 gear score. We are also getting a hardcore season server for players who want more pain. You will start with a level 60 character and only use the provided gear. You start with 230 AP and 280 DP, which you can enhance up to 260 AP and 300 DP. This server is PvP on all the time with no restrictions, but you don't have to worry about dying because you will simply go to jail and wait for a couple of days to get out. And yes, days, not hours, to earn rest points. You can also duel 1v1 in the jail to earn points so you can get out. There is also a ranking system which will give you rewards based on how long you survive, fights you won, and numbers of deaths. This will surely not invite players to exploit the game and survive 365 days glitching under the map or inside the wall of the game or even feed kills. We are also getting new accessories, which is kind of okay, and I think they forgot to mention the 200% black spirit changes for each class. There is also a hint of a demon lord castle, which is kind of exciting, and time traveling. Now, I know I sounded like unhappy and ungrateful, but the truth is that I want this game to be better. But as time goes by, you'll realize that there are things in the game that really needs improvement, and most of the time, what the devs are doing are just putting bandages on the problems that they create. There are still so many issues in the game that has never been addressed, like for example, damage numbers, random stutters or frame drops, and many more. What do you guys think about the June 2024 Heidel Ball updates? Write it in the comments down below. I would love to hear what you guys have to say, and thank you for watching and have a nice day.